shuttle, don't wait for me. Your time is up, better save it, please. I just ran up me an 80 piece. You know what I'm saying? Be like you're pregnant. Dogging that bitch till her face full of Maybelline. In my cup, maybe easily. We don't do no yeah, for some Billie Jean, Billie Jean, Billie Jean. Drop the heat popping, no signs of him stopping. He need all his profits, I'm saying he ain't copy. I know that he got it, he free. Bitch, I'm from the trap, it's exotic. I'm smoking Supreme, had the box it. 458, bro, I take off like rockets. It's my body, kid, like Buffy the body.
I'm made back on the game, it's got it too hard. In my Mexican bitch, treat me like Lady March. I threw 20,000 on 25 strangers. Been raised by QC, prepare me for the danger. My stick got a spot like a Texas Park Ranger. I'm stuck to my blood.
Off, let the homie go handle it. Be pointing stones on my neck like they run like a
What's up, YouTube? So before we get into the Street Hawkers, let's talk about these. The 1992 Huaraches. I've been looking for these my size in a long time. The 1992 version. You're never going to get them perfect, and you're always going to get them with yellowing right there. Okay? It's inevitable. This pair is in pretty good condition. On the back, as you see, when they retroed them, you see how it's a part of the material is just kind of like embossed out. That's how the originals were back then, man. High quality, man. Look at this shoe. This was originally in 1991 made, but if you look on the back, they didn't drop them to 1992. See that 92 in before? And a lot of Nikes were made in Korea back in the days. This was when Bo Jackson hurt his hip, had to get hip replacement surgery in 1991. And what happened is in 1992-ish, they presented a commercial with Bo Jackson working, lifting weights. This was the first hardcore trainer that Nike came. I still have the Nike Air in there. That is awesome. This is one of the most hardcore trainers back in the days that Nike Air came out with. And like I said, this is the Huarache. And they actually have a unit in here. Okay, you can't see it. This is when they start making units within the sole. You couldn't see it. And of course, you've got the window, okay? The window right here. We call it, this was the Huarache thing. And I'm not sure if this came before the Air Jordan 7s or not, but they were both made in 92 and they both had the style enclosure cutout. I think these were actually made before the 1992 Air Jordans, but long time ago, man. It is what it is, but very excited to have these in the collection, the OGs. You know what? I don't know how you maybe couldn't hear me over this, so. All right, so we back at it, all right? So, I apologize if you couldn't hear me on the 1992 OGs, but you will hear me on the Nike SB Street Hawkers. The reason why I wanted to pick these up is I was excited to have the Ben and Jerry's in my collection. I actually have two pairs of those, and I should have brought them out here to compare, but I already made a video. I'll just shoot back some of the video. But once again, look at that. Got these from StockX. They originally was 110. I think I ended up paying like 640, 710 in all. The price has dropped a little bit right now, so it's actually a darn good time to buy these. But bruh, quality wise, this shoe is way, way better than the Nike Ben & Jerry's. Way better than the Ben & Jerry's, man, on the side. And there's a million reviews on these. At first, I didn't want to do a review, but I figured that I'd throw it in 4K so you could kind of see the quality and the stitching of it. The leather on here is really good, man. It's SBs never disappoint except on the Ben & Jerry's. The quality on the leather quality on the Ben & Jerry's was terrible, man. It was so cheap whenever it bent. It just looked so bad. It was a permanent bend, and I normally don't care about those things, but it looked really bad. And but on this side, on the right shoe, they actually have like some fidgety suede. I call them fidgety suede. It's really cool. It'll probably stretch off after some wears, get a little nappy, but it is what it is. This white portion guarantees you to get dirty. But a lot of people haven't talked about that. We see how they have blue threading right up in here, there's great threading wrapped around this version. Inside, like I say, you've got the neon green, and this shoe wholly was based off the Japanese meals. On the side, this brown area is chopsticks, everything. This is like noodles or something. There's a whole scenario breakdown of these shoes on other channels. I'd hate to copy one of them, and I'm not. I'm just gonna show you the different materials that they used on this, man. You see how they have two different materials on the back? A lot of people just, they're not really, they're covering what they stand for, but not the actual differences of materials. You see how they have the brown leather and the black stitching. Then you got the white stitching. And man, look at this. It's just like a canvas material wrapped around here. But this is like a light blue at the top, but it's real soft leather. Both of the leathers are really great. And this is a smooth, I don't know what this is. I don't know what kind of material this is on the side. I couldn't tell you. It's not suede. I don't know what it is. I have no idea what this is, but looks like something got on there. But anyway, you're never going to get a shoe perfect from StockX. It just doesn't exist, bro. Because I don't think Nike makes perfect shoes. But the swoosh is actually gray on here. It's a nice leather. This shoe right now, if you can find this shoe, and look at this, I wanted to show you this real quick. If you could find this shoe, see how the laces are just white and wrapped down here? If you could find this shoe for like $600 right now, buy. This is gonna be a $1,000 shoe easily. For y'all you people that care about prices so much, it's gonna be a $1,000 shoe. But this is how my shoe actually came laced up. Look at this. This lace was wrapped up and entangled in this lace. I don't know if that has anything to do with the food comparison, but this is how it came. And hold on, let me flip this through. Dunk Pros, it's burnt orange amongst this top area right here. And above here, it's like a banana type of yellow. Definitely an amazing shoe, man. Definitely amazing shoe. I can't wait to wear these. I have nowhere to go. But there's a million videos on these. A lot better. I just want you to get some definition of 4K on these. And just show you that if you can get these for $600, you need to cop for sure, okay? You need to cop these joints for sure. Not going to do on foot. Because there's, like I said, there's a whole bunch of videos of people doing on foot for these, man. But look at that. That's tight, man. That is tight.